Hey everyone, today is the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. It's December 8th, and this is a holy day of obligation for us as Catholics, particularly because it is something that is so important to our teaching for the Church. When we talk about the Immaculate Conception, it can be easy. I know when I was a kid to think that this is about Jesus, that this is, everything's about Jesus, right? But it doesn't relate to Jesus particularly, at least at the beginning here, because it's not his conception we're talking about, but the conception of his mother Mary, that Mary was conceived without sin, that Mary was preserved from the contagion of original sin from her birth. And what that means for us is very profound, because it says that God wanted to create in Mary a worthy dwelling place for his Son. It is saying that this is the first action on God's part, that the first part of his redeeming action for all humankind. It's kind of the first light in the darkness for us as human beings. Today in our liturgy, the readings kind of juxtapose these two parts of humanity's state. So we have this reading from the book of Genesis, which illustrates the fall of Adam and Eve, or right after that, how they gave in to their sinfulness, to their pride, and they sinned against God, did what God said not to do. And so it is those curses that they invoke upon themselves in the garden, and then we have Eve as mother of all the living. It says that right at the end of this passage that we hear today, that Eve is mother of all the living. But then we see Mary in the gospel, and she is visited by the angel Gabriel, and he tells her that she is going to bear a son. She's to name him Jesus. He will save his people. And Mary, although she doesn't know what all of this means, she says yes. She says, "I'm the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done to me according to your will." Her yes is, it counteracts the no of our first parents in the garden. Her yes is the redeeming virtue of humankind now. And in Mary now, we see what is possible for us as human beings, that we too can have that same virtue, that we can say yes to God, and God then will greatly bless our yes. So on this feast day of the Immaculate, of the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Virgin Mary, we are given wonder and hope. Hope for our state as human beings, because Mary has been preserved from original sin. Mary has been preserved from sin, but she is to be a model for us of what God is wanting to heal in each and every one of us. That God wants to heal us of our sins, wants to redeem us, and bring him to himself. And so we ask the intercession of Mary today that it may be so, that we might cooperate with that grace of God in our lives, and that we might too know the grace of being redeemed by the Father.